What's up, you all? It has requested the man, Mr. Bruno Mars, Valerie tribute to Amy Winehouse. Come on, let's get right into it. I wonder what year this was. You better kill that tambourine right off the bat. This feels so good, this music. I like that little rod there. That disconnected, bro. I want choreography. That band is amazing, first and foremost. Y'all know how I feel about a good band. I gotta give props. And why did they seem dead the entire performance? Ridiculous. Maybe they were sad. I don't know. But some just looked like they were... I'll be honest. Some just looked stoned out of their mind. Like, what's the point of being there if you go... Nonetheless, absolutely incredible. The band was incredible. The oohs and ahs, the little quartet moment that the background singers had, That felt so good. All of this music, this live band, this upbeat, literally and figuratively, very upbeat. Just a lovely song, and Amy Winehouse did an incredible job on that song. And this is a beautiful song, and I like her because she didn't sound like she was from this era. She didn't give two craps about what was going on around her, the industry, what they want, what everybody else is doing. Completely her own, complete different thing she was doing. And Bruno is doing that, is doing exactly this now. And maybe the past album or two albums, he's been doing that too, just doing his own thing, giving homage to past performers, and he is selling like crazy. You know what I mean? So I mean, just awesome feel good music for everybody. He tore it up, and his range is just ridiculous, and he just keeps going higher and higher and higher, and his stamina too. It's not easy just going and going and going like that. He Oh, it's a him and Beyonce band. When it comes to the voice slash performance, them two together, is nobody else has touched them today. They're some of the greatest performances of all time. But today, they are the best, in my opinion, by far. They are the best performers slash singers, period. Their stamina and their vocal ability is just unmatched together, and Mr. Bruno is just one of the greatest. He really is. I mean, his tone, and like I always say with male singers with higher voices, it's touchy for me, because a lot of times, in my opinion, they can sound a bit whiny, a bit thin, whiny, strainy, just no, but Bruno, his natural tone and his placement and that wide open sound, it sounds natural, it sounds smooth. His voice is always smooth, regardless of the octave where he is in his range. Always smooth, always suave. And a slight, just a slight, I'm not sure if rasp is the word, maybe a slight sort of smokiness to his tone. Maybe that's the right word, just a slight smokiness, but still smooth and suave, And I mean, it was just dope, and I like that. That run when you it's like a break. I like that. I like that. Very old school. I'm trying to think of who is the singer. This is it, Little Richard, that was the man who sang, "Why do fools? Why do they fall in love? Why do fools?" That he used to do that. Y'all let me know which one. I'm sorry, I can't think of, I can think of the name. I don't think it's Little Richard, but that's all I think about, that guy who sings that. Anyway, incredible performance, incredible band. The background singers, a quartet moment, sickening. He was sickening. The audience, tired, bland. Sorry. Thank you for liking and subscribing. Continue to worry for your speech.